Can someone draw Jack in a skin tight outfit like DV now? Because that's who I would be, the small Korean girl in a mech suit. Yep. You can't tell me names. I don't know all of their names. So Zarya, I don't know who that is. I have not liked playing as Tracer, the butt gate lady, the lady whose butt broke the internet.
She's got a butt.
She's got it. Everyone.
That woman has a butt.
How dare she? I don't like playing as her, mostly by just because I don't get it. I haven't played as her a lot. She does these like warping powers where she can like kind of teleport small short distances, so she's like fast, and I don't quite get it, but. But so far, I've really enjoyed a lot of Overwatch, and I look forward to playing it more. Rich, why are you looking at that vagina?
I guess hell's full of vaginas.
Hell's full of vaginas. Which one is May? You can't tell me names. I don't know any of their names yet. Zarya is the giant Russian lady. She's interesting. I've been trying to play as her more lately, just because her weapon set is very interesting. Yes.
Yeah, my hands wet.
Oh God.
What?
Your hands are wet.
Yeah.
Now you're looking at hell.
I didn't dry my hands well enough. That's my fault.
And that's my fault. Yeah. I have not played Battleborn, though. No. You guys told me Battleborn was a MOBA. And I don't want to play no MOBA. May is the ice girl. Oh, yeah. She has some very interesting strategies. And... Yeah, I like it. Like, she can... She has a power to build an ice wall, which doesn't hurt anybody. You know, can't do any damage, but it could act as a shield, or it could act as a method to block your enemy's progression. So you can kind of force them into a tighter area. So then someone with like a grenade launcher, like the guy with the grenade launcher, can easily lob grenades into the tight area. Like, their strategy. It's great. It's great.
Oh, God, I suck.
Well, did you lose it?
No.
Did you lose it, Rich? Get it back.
Never should have went to the bathroom.
Never. Nope. Hold it in. It just makes you twitchier. Young bubbies, you don't need to fit into the community. You just need to enjoy the game. Don't worry about fitting into the community.
Why do you need to fit into a community?
Oh, they were joking.
Oh, okay.
Young Bubby says, I want to fit in with all this Overwatch community chat. Have you guys seen the sweet hardcore rim job hentai of Tracer? there's apparently a lot of pornography out there.
Didn't the game Overwatch just come out?
Yeah. No. Lot of pornography.
Ammo, yes.
This is Brutal Doom, Ivan Lee. Are you running any specific mods
besides? Ultimate Doom Visor. Other than that, it's just Brutal Doom.
Brutal Doom with the Ultimate Doom Visor.
Yeah, which basically gives me the heads-up display I've got. Mm-hmm. That fancy. I'm looking out of my visor and... You can kind of see your face reflected when the screen's dark enough. You can see, like, your eyes.
Yeah, the beta, and it was an open beta. Like, not only has it been in beta for a while, it was an open beta, which means, you know, everyone has been playing it.
Two of them. Where'd the other one go? Did he glitch?
Did he?
Unless I'm seeing things. Maybe I'm just fucking seeing things. I don't know. Maybe in hell you see things.
Word to your mother, I don't think Blizzard actually tried to crack down on the porn. I think they told people they were going to crack down on the porn.
Shit.
and then did nothing because it's good. It's good for their bottom line to keep their fan base happy. So they probably like made a statement like, "Hey, everybody, cool it down with all this porn based off of our characters." Completely unrelated. Here's an easy way to make custom character models. Do whatever you want with them, but hey, lay off of those adult images. Don't you do it.
I should have held on to that kiss in here. Oh well, never mind.
Right, Orange Stray Cat? Like, here are links to the porn that we don't want you to watch. Here are the links right here. You watch that, but oh, don't you click on them. I'm sure that's what's happening.
I can die. That's it? Just two cacos? All right, I'll take that.
We have not discussed Hail Hydra yet. I can't, Rich doesn't care. Rich hasn't been in a comic book store in 20 years.
I did hear about it though, so if you want to talk about it, we can talk about it.
I just don't care. It's going to be another one of those things.
It's going to be so undone sooner rather than later.
Yep. Yep, it's going to be incredibly undone. I just, you know.
Let's assassinate Captain America's character for publicity!
Yep. No, he was a triple agent this whole time!
Let's spit in the face of everyone who liked this character!
For some cheap, easy money! No, it's... I don't care. For those who don't know, in a reboot of Captain America comics, it turned out that he has been an agent of Hydra this whole time.
Didn't they actually have him murder somebody on panel?
Possibly. I don't care. I'm not reading it. I don't care. Nobody cares.
Well, I'm sure Captain America fans do. They probably care a great deal.
Jack, Spider-Man is in Civil War because his powers are particularly useful for capturing people who need to be arrested and without harm. Sure. I understand why he's in the movie. It's not 100% necessary that he's in the movie. And it doesn't take away from the fact that it's a bloated movie. That's two movies in a movie. If that happened in Avengers Civil War, I think it would have made a lot more sense. Instead, it happened in Captain America Civil War. As I discussed last time we talked about Civil War, there needed to be two movies here. Captain America The Winter Soldier Part 2 and Avengers Civil War. They could have fleshed out a lot more ideas. There's the Doom face. Now you can really see his eyes.
Yeah. What's behind me? Nothing's behind me. All right. All right. We're good.
Good.
One man and his trusty shotgun. That's what this game's about.
Are you guys doing the spoilers discussion proper tonight? Yeah, we had our Civil War discussion.
I don't have much to say about it. I don't even remember most of the film at this point.
That's the thing, where it's like, it's fine. It has some flaws. There's not as much to unpack as there was in, say, a Batman versus Superman. Jesus H. Christ, Rich.
That's Doom.
Doom. Jack wrong? I'm sure I'm wrong about a lot of things. You guys tell me so all the time.
I should have grabbed one of those for... I won't. Big deal. As
you guys know, I'm a horrible Marvel fanboy. So I think it's all right. I think the Civil War has a lot of flaws. Mostly, it's two disparate storylines that had no right being in the same movie. But it's fine. That's it. Let's all be honest here. We are all much more excited for the Half in the Bag episode for a comic movie than the comic movie itself. You know, sometimes. Sometimes you just see a movie so you can talk to your friends about it, and you know, that's fine. That's fine.
There goes all my fucking shotgun ammo.
Are you guys completely sick of Pickle Dick Bandersnatch yet, or will Doctor Strange be another jolt of fun like Ant-Man or Guardians of the Galaxy? I worry that it will be more Ant-Man than Guardians, and I think Ant-Man is not as good as Guardians. If that means anything. It could be a fun movie. Magic, though, is a strange realm. Or it could be very boring. I like him as an actor. Cucumber Cabbage Patch.
What?
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Ooh.
Lady Boner Sandy Pants. But I've never cared about Doctor Strange. Like, you know, I feel very similar to Doctor Strange as I felt about Ant-Man, where I never cared about him as a character before, so I don't know if I will care about him now. You know?
Right.
So, if it's a good movie, that's great. If it's not, it's no skin off my nuts. Jack says, Hans Frosch, does the look or setting of a game have a defining impact on how you like it?
Yes.
Or is sheer gameplay of paramount importance? I find myself rarely uninterested in anything too flashy, i.e. Overwatch.
The example I've used before.
Use it.
You take Ninja Gaiden.
Yeah.
And all the ninjas and monsters you fight, mm-hmm. and replace them all with teddy bears. And instead of sword slashes, it's you're blowing kisses.
But it's the same kind
of... Same kind of timings on the attacks and everything. Yeah. You jump at the same height, you dash at the same speed... But you're sending hugs and kisses around instead of swords and blood.
It could be kind of fun.
In a different way.
Would it
be the same game?
My direct comparison is Bloodborne versus Dark Souls 3. Very similar gameplay. Obviously made by the same company. And I could not get into Dark Souls 3. And I think a lot of that had to do with the world and the setting. I really enjoy horror movies, and so I loved the horror setting of Bloodborne, and that got me over a lot of humps. Whereas Dark Souls 3 didn't have that for me. It didn't have the blood. It didn't have the...
Can't stealth kill them for some reason. That's fine.
You know, it didn't have what Bloodborne had, and so I...
Fucker! fuck.
I think it's partially important. If the gameplay is so amazing, I don't think it matters.
Playing two goddamn conservatives, I don't want to die. Fuck it. I'm shooting you all with my shotgun.
Jack, were there better motivations for Captain America and Iron Man, or were the motivations for Captain America and Iron Man better in the film than they were in the Civil War comic? No. No, the comic raised the stakes a lot more.
BFG!
You did it. The comic book, for anyone who doesn't know, the whole reason the Superhero Registration Act was enacted was because a group of D-list heroes accidentally killed, like, what, a school full of children?
Kindergarten, I think, wasn't
it? Yeah. They accidentally sent a villain, they were going after a villain who exploded himself in a kindergarten and killed a bunch of children.
Because the villain who explodes himself, exploded. Shockingly enough.
That was the start of the Civil War comic, which I thought was wonderful. It killed all the heroes as well. And a bunch of children. And so then it was like, all right, let's get it together. The in the movie, it was because they exploded like a room of a hotel and like 12 people who were all delegates of Wakanda died. Obviously, there were bigger things that were happening.
Look at this. Doing with stealth mechanics, who'd have thought?
Speedball survived. Oh, it's been a while since I've read the comics. But in any case, I thought that was much more impactful and in the comic books. And that actually raised the question of, like, what are these people doing?
Will it? Can I stealth kill them?
Oh, probably not. If you can't stealth kill the pinkies. No,
no, I can't. No, I can't.
But I love that you tried, Rich. I love that you tried. I really like the Civil War comic. It ended
out of control quickly.
Yep. I think it did not end well, the Civil War comic, but I really liked the premise. I liked the first trade. The first trade was pretty good. Nice.
Nah, it's so nice. I lost a fuck ton of health.
Also, like, in the movie, something we've talked about before is, you know, like, each of them has one line of dialogue to kind of make their argument, and that's basically it. Whereas in the comic books, there was a little more back and forth.
What do we got in here? What do we got in here?
Right, the book's always better. Goo. Let me read this. Hold on. Anonymous, let me read this story first. Hold on.
Do I get trapped if I go down here? I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. Oh, it looks like a door down there. Armor! All right. Still lost a ton of health, but I made a lot of it back.
Oh, good. Rich, would you like to take a break and do a dramatic reading?
Of what?
Of this.
Yeah.
Would you be at all interested in doing a dramatic reading? What is this called, Rich?
Doom, Repercussions of Evil. John Stalivern waited. The lights above him blinked and sparked out of the air. There were demons in the base. He didn't see them, but had expected them for years. His warnings to Colonel Johnson... What? His warnings to Colonel Joson were not listened to, and now it was too late. Far too late for now, anyway. John was a space marine for 14 years. When he was young, he watched the spaceships, and he said to Dad, "I want to be on the ships, Daddy." Dad said, "No. You'll be killed by demons!" There was a time when he believed him. Then as he got older, he stopped. But now, in the space station base of the UAC, he knew there were demons. "This is Joson," the radio crackered. "You must fight the demons!" So John got at his plasma rifle and blew up the wall. "He's going to kill us!" said the demons. "I will shoot him," said the cyber demon, and he fired the rocket missiles. John plasmaed at him and tried to blow him up. But then the ceiling fell and they were trapped and not able to kill. "No, I must kill the demons," he shouted. The radio said, "No, John. You are the demons." And then John was a zombie. Okay, too many flubs. That can be edited.
I have no idea what that was. Anonymous.
It's a reference to some kind of really bad Half-Life fan fiction. I know that much.
Is that what it is? Yes. Anonymous wanted Rich to read that. Anonymous, don't worry. You don't need to worry about any further tipping. He said he would tip more if you read it, but your initial tip was good enough to read it. Thank you, Anonymous. But I thought that was a fine reading, Rich. You can edit that together, I'm sure. You are the demon, and then he was a zombie. That's a fine ending. Fine ending. A fine, fine ending.
All right, what am I missing?
This new subscriber says, thank you for dancing, monkeys.
That's what we're here for.
That's what we're here for. Here to kill demons and dance.
I'm missing a blue door. Why am I missing a blue door?
I do not know.
Why don't you know?
Because I have not played this game very often, and I certainly, when I played it, did not get all the way to hell. That's for sure.
Where is this?
Oh.
I'm the least familiar with this particular episode of Doom.
Well, it's the last one, you know.
Like, you know, episode one. I know, like, the back of my fucking hand.
Absolutely.
Not worth the damage I'm going to take. Apparently it is because I fell. All right. Oh, that wasn't bad. Oh, it wasn't bad.
Oi.
Oi, everything's all right.
Oh, I think that wasn't bad. I
can't find that door. Where's that door? Oh, here it is. All right.
Can't find the door. Where's the door?
And then he was a zombie.
And then you are the demon. No, you are the demon.
House of Pain.
Rich, someone's asking if you've ever read any of the Doom books.
Yes, they're terrible. The first book is really just like a level by level description of the first game.
Oh,
like,
really?
It's, for some reason, they took a game that has no story, and they decided to be extremely faithful to it. It's really bizarre reading.
Sounds like it. You know what? Sounds like it. What is today? Oh, today's the 29th.
Ooh, I didn't even know that was here.
Oh.
I just randomly found another secret. All right. I've expanded my Doom knowledge.
Well, congratulations, Rich. On your Doom knowledge expansion.
Door or teleporter? Door.
Door.
Door was the right choice.
Let's see here. Oh, also, I didn't thank Camille Jaxa for your tip. Thanks, Camille. Still finding new secrets in Doom, Rich.
Yep.
That's what you're doing. That's what you're doing.
Very fortunate to have found so much shotgun ammo in hell.
Rich, do you have any plans or want to see the Warcraft movie?
No.
Yeah, and I know so little about the world of Warcraft.
And Warcraft is a thing.
Yes. That's
seem to like thing.
That is literally the extent of my knowledge. Warcraft is a thing.
Enemies show up, enemies while I've got vulnerability going on. And that just ended. Alright. Mm-hmm. Oh shit.
The characters don't have big floppy mouths. Immersion ruined. I have a very good friend who still to this day.
Alright. I don't know anything about what you're talking about. You have big floppy mouths.
I think that's like a character animation thing in World of Warcraft.
Oh.
I have a very good friend who still plays World of Warcraft to this day with like the same guild he's been playing with for the past like 10 years.
Yeah.
And I'm very interested in what someone like him thinks of the movie. Someone who's like a huge Warcraft person. Because that's the only people this movie is made for, right?
Mm-hmm.
Possibly you're going to get some, like, Lord of the Rings crossover because it looks like a fantasy epic. But can't imagine there's going to be that much new blood coming into the Warcraft movie.
I don't have a plasma gun yet. That's interesting.
You don't have a plasma gun yet?
Probably. I'm just sure there was one somewhere and I missed it. That's probably how that went down.
Redagul Ultima. I've been playing Overwatch and I'm liking it.
All right, we're doing good. Must that open something over here? Nope. Never gets old.
What? I know a girl who's played WoW for 13 years and she thinks the movie looks like total shit. Possibly, but you know, like it'd be interesting, you know, like someone who's a huge Warcraft person and someone who's just a movie person. From the maker of Moon? The guy who directed Moon made the Warcraft movie? That's fucked up. That's quite a change of pace. MadSec 5, this looks exactly like Doom. I don't know what you're talking about. This looks exactly like Doom.
Oh, nice room. Yeah, I don't know what's in there. Yeah, I should have done some stealth kills.
Eh, probably. You know what? Probably.
There's nothing in there but death.
You're playing Doom on. Why are you playing Doom on potato quality? Yep, this is exactly what happens when you turn the settings on Doom down.
Potato quality.
I think it's just a joke because, you know, the new Doom.
I think there's a high-res texture pack, but I think it looks like crap.
Oh.
I don't want my Doom to look fancy. I want it to look like Doom.
No, I think it was a joke, Rich. Like we were playing New Doom.
You think? Do you know?
I'm 90%.
I'm not interested in think.
90%, Rich. Can you take the shot at 90%?
No.
Hmm. Okay, that's fair. Okay, what? What's happening?
Things are being shot.
Hans Frosch says, AFAIK in today's games. I don't know what AFAIK.
As far as I know.
As far as I know, in today's games, you can rarely get stuck in a situation that renders it unwinnable. Which IIRC...
So many acronyms.
What's IIRC? Which IIRC was quite different in the past. What do you think about the absence of this mechanic nowadays? The question I pose to you, Hans Afrosh, is was that a mechanic or was that a limitation of programming and lack of forethought? Nice BFG usage. Grenade!
Also not in Vanilla Doom. The grenade.
So what do you think about getting stuck in an unwinnable situation?
Give me an example. That's very vaguely
defined. Like in a Sierra text adventure game. You know, if you didn't do point A in the second step, you can't do point B in the fourth step.
I don't think you should be locked off like that. Mm-hmm. If you ever get to a point where you can't win, it just be the end. You should know.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can't think of any games that's happened in other than old adventure games.
Well, yeah, that's what came to my mind.
All right.
Fall off a ledge into a pit that you can't get out of? Unless that's a glitch, I don't know when that's happened. I guess it's possible, but...
You should be able to load up one of your old saves.
Yeah. Meeble, I think it's just bad game design in general. I don't think it has anything to do with... like an old way of doing things.
Right.
If you die, you die.
But if you fall into a pit where there's no exit, you're not dying in the pit, that's bad design.
Yeah. The only winning move is not to play. Oh, they're saying apparently Doom had levels like that.
Really?
In the original Doom, where if you could get stuck somewhere.
Never happened to me. Hmm.
Doom is an old game. Here's
my question. In the game proper or in fan levels?
Ooh.
And how would this happen? I guess all pits, yeah.
Yeah. Well, and really, like I said, I don't think that was a mechanic.
I can think of some pits you can fall in where you couldn't get out, but there was some kind of like toxic waste at the bottom of the pit and you would eventually die. They could have made it quicker.
Sure.
But it was essentially just like... falling into a pit of lava. Oh, you're dead.
Right. And then you just have to be like, oh, I guess I gotta wait here for a minute and a half to die. Sure, okay, I'm with you.
Oh, no, I don't want rocket launcher. God. Close quarters rocket launcher? Let's see. No, not gonna happen.
A Fistful of Metal says the original Halo had a system of autosave that could lead to being stuck where you would autosave on a high up ledge that can't get and you can't get down.
That's autosave's problem. I'm a proponent of manual save. Mm-hmm. Both are fine, manual and checkpoint, like autosave.
Yeah.
But there's no reason you shouldn't be able to manage your own damn saves.
Mm-hmm. Well, and really, it's not a mechanic. It was just a way that they poorly designed games before they knew better. And hopefully we know better now.
Yeah. Alright. Nothing is jumping out at me. Alright, bring me back there. That brings me back there, right? Let's go left. That brings me back here.
Oh, well, there you go.
I'm going to guess they all do. All right. So what am I supposed to do?
The goat head on the wall. I don't know. You got me, Rich.
Something's supposed to open up that did not.
I have no idea.
Chat saying anything about this?
What? Oh, sorry. I stopped paying attention for a minute. I kind of fell off into a zone of something else. Let's see here.
Because if you guys jinx me by talking about getting soft locked and then hear it happen, I'm going to be very upset.
Nah, they're still talking about Warcraft movie.
I stepped on just the right one.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, guys. Not Match Sex 5 says, hey, guys, I'm studying hypnosis. Anyone here a girl? is there any game coming out in the near future that you are particularly looking forward to?
There was Doom, but that's come and gone. So
I know you were really looking forward to Doom. I had no expectations of Doom because I was never a Doom guy.
Yeah,
I was really looking forward to Overwatch, and I'm pleasantly surprised. So, as far as what's coming out next that I'm really looking forward to, no, I have nothing next new that I'm looking forward to. I know they said No Man's Sky got delayed a little bit, which, you know. Big game, it's fine.
Shit happens.
I have nothing upcoming that I can remember off of the top of my head. I'm right now I just want to play more Overwatch. I just want more time in my day to play Overwatch. Let's see here. Traitor to Zinch. To Traitor Tot Zinch. Says, to answer your question, Jack, as someone who has played every Warcraft game since 1994 when I was 5, I thought the movie was a serviceable bit of fantasy spectacle. It's just okay. Okay, so that's a hardcore fan, and they have not impressed him. That's okay. I like Overwatch. I think it's fun. I think it's good. It's engaging. It's teamwork. I like teamwork in my team shooters.
Right, so I gotta get the things to open up.
Traitor to Tznich. Sneech. I don't know what that means.
It means traitor to Finich.
Tznich.
Tznich. Tznich. Traitor to Tznich.
Fudu V says Overwatch is the Paul Rudd of video games. So average, yet has appeal. It's something more than average, you know. He's got that spark. Overwatch has got that spark, just like Paul Rudd. It's pronounced Zinch. Okay. Okay. Zinch. Zinch apparently is one of the four chaos gods in Warhammer. Well, thank you, Van. Zinch. Chaos god in Warhammer.
That Marina's with me. He needs to die so I can grab his plasma rifle.
You know what? Yeah, new Pokemon's coming out. I guess you're right. So maybe a little excited for that. Haven't really thought about it since the
announcement. I know I am.
Rich, on the other hand, is very excited about the new Pokemon.
What's this yellow key?
Oh, I don't know.
I'm the least familiar with these maps.
Fair.
I'm assuming it's going to lead to the secret level.
Ooh, there's a secret?
Yeah, I don't know where the hell the door for it is.
Oh.
And the normal exit is here.
Sure.
And I'm probably just going to take it. Just fuck it. Jesus!
Doom! Doom! Doom's gonna demon you up.
They certainly did.
Yep. And Camille Jaxa, thank you for your tip. Get you, Rich, you need your murder hose. Where's your murder hose?
I was using it. Is that all that was in there? Just a fucking power cell?
And demons. And demons to shoot.
That's fine.
Don't forget about the demons.
I don't just want demons, Jack. I want victory.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, kill 78. Oh, yeah, I missed it. I'm sure. It's fine. It's fine. We're almost there.
The tip banner, for some reason, is not showing up. I don't know why. Sorry, can't tell you. It's on. It might just need an OBS restart, which obviously we can't do midstream, so.
Fucking deal with it.
So, if I'm seeing your tips and I'm reading your tips. Got it up here, so sorry that it's not popping up and saying, oh my God. But it's what it's doing. Catacrawler, no, I have not finished Dark Souls 3 because I was not terribly into it. I got pretty far. I'm going to say I at least got like, oh, nice, like 12, 15 hours, maybe more. Somewhere 12 to 15 hours is what I got into it.
All right.
Anonymous says, are you guys fans of the Resident Evil games and hoping for an announcement for 7 in this year's E3?
No.
No. Resident Evil 4, I really liked. And then, you know, that's about it.
Why do people keep thinking I don't hate survival horror? Why is that not something that's been dispelled by this point?
Maybe they're new and they don't know?
Maybe.
I tell you, I was never a fan of, like, the original Resident Evils. I hated the whole fixed camera thing. But I liked it. I think Resident Evil 4 was fine. It was a good game. Rich hates. Right? Rich hates. Oh yeah, there's a light fire crackling noise in this level, and someone's saying it's making them sleepy.
Enjoy your nap.
Just pay attention to the shotguns.
Caught a tree. Okay, here we go.
That whole fixed camera. It was. I just didn't care for it. I know the intention of the stationary camera in Resident Evil was to, you know, add suspense to make controlling a little more difficult. It's just not something I cared for. I get it. Didn't care for it.
Whoa, where did you come from? All right. Shit got real.
Death hose.
Oh, right now my landmass is gone. Let's hope that lava doesn't hurt me too much. Yeah. Said I wasn't gonna jump, but I didn't.
You didn't jump?
No.
Done.
All right, where's the shotgun guy? I know I heard that. You gotta be up in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're in there, and you're fucking dead now, you prick.
I like Resident Evil 4. I thought it was nice and
fuck it.
Nice and schlocky.
All right, where do you guys go? Very little out of. Oh, that's probably the other side. I don't know. Which one did I go? Yes, there we go.
A secret is revealed.
Almost done with the episode. I finally fucking found the plasma gun. Whoa, what's behind me?
Floaties! My Rich, it's the floaty heads. You know them. They got floaties in the heads. Yeah, we both enjoyed Dead Space. It's, you know, it was fun while we were playing it. It seemed like a good game. Just not forever on the list, you know?
It wasn't my favorite thing ever, but yeah, it was enjoyable.
Yeah. Just forever on the list of things to play. Regimund Ringek says, if there were a space cop game, what kind of game would you want it to be? Besides, of course, a Doom clone.
Doom clone makes the most sense.
Doom clone is what makes the most sense thematically. It would be a Doom clone with only the BFG. That's what it would
Yeah.
be. Hansafrosh, in other news, CNN reports that scientists have discovered the largest known sea sponge off the coast of Hawaii. Now isn't that something?
That is something.
Do you guys like sponges? I do. They're soft and funny looking. Thanks, Hansafrosh. It's weird, but sure, that's great. Largest sea sponge. Thanks for sharing.
Oh, I think I'm going to end this right now. I'd like to find more armor first. Is that gonna happen? Probably not.
What you need is a Doom clone with only the BFG. But there's a one-liner score multiplier. So you get a score for as many guys as you kill, right? And if you can choose the proper one-liner to say after you defeat guys, then you get bonus points. That's the space cop game right there.
I'm just gonna watch these two fight.
Okay. And kill the victor.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
That's how Doom works.
Latch Dannon. You guys are great. Rich, what? As a fan of Thief.
Yeah.
What did you think of Dishonored?
I need to play it.
I'm
going to go over this for the 19th time. I started playing it back before I had my new computer. So it ran like crap. Ran like wet crap. I was getting like 20
like
frames.
Wet crap.
I was getting like 20 frames a second.
Uh-huh.
So I just put it away, and I'm like, well, I'll get to it some other day, sometime in the future, and I got a better computer. I got a better computer now.
Yeah.
I just haven't gotten around to it yet.
We have to play a lot of games.
All right.
And that's not something that Rich wants to start on stream, because it's a game he thinks he might enjoy, so he wants to actually take some time and learn it on his own before he has the pressure of doing it live.
Yeah.
And the distractions, you know.
The distraction of talking to people.
That's the other thing.
play the game and take it in.
It's tough to play a game when you're trying to have a conversation, when you're listening to other people. It's distracting.
Exit's around here fucking somewhere. I better find it before this invulnerability runs off or I'm fucked. There we go. There we go. Easy. Easy.
Nice, Rich. No death run. Confirmed.
Two more stages, and I've beaten Doom.
Nice. So far, everyone. This has been a no death run so far.
Change shortly. Get on the ball here.
Trolley, Rich, hop on it. Killmeister says, spoiler alert, Dishonored is awesome.
Oh, wow, that sucked. Oh, wow, that sucked. Oh, my God, it's not over. Fucking die!
Does this, Sarah Chen says, does this mean Phoenix Wright most likely going to be played alone? No, we do want to finish that, at least that case. I want to finish it. And I'm definitely more willing to try a new game on stream than Rich, but no, we want to...
Phoenix Wright, we kind of know what this
is. And now we know, yeah, and we do need to finish that soon.
I don't need to be intimately familiar, just... I think we tend to have bad streams with games when we're playing them for just completely blind.
Well, just trying to figure out the control scheme. Yeah. Fuck, man. Yeah.
All right. Oh, God. I hate this map.
Pew.
Yeah, I mean, something's gonna eat me.
Looks like someone ate a shotgun shell.
I'm just so close to not dying. I know there's a lot of people who are just great at this game, and it's really a pathetic achievement.
Ah.
But
it's still an achievement, Rich. Right, exactly, chat, like Dark Souls. Remember when we first tried to play Dark Souls on stream? And by the way, and how helpful you were. But, you know, that's a game we probably may have enjoyed more outside, and obviously now we're more into the whole Soulsborne series.
What do you do?
What do you do?
I hit the switch, and something happens. I don't know what happens, but I hit the switch.
What's going on? What's the demons?
What did it do?
Oh, a secret was revealed, Rich.
I'm going to hold off on that one. Yeah.
Oh.
We'll keep that nice armor intact before we fight the main...
Oh, sure.
Guy
sure.
At the end of this, I'll do some min-maxing.
Ooh, nice.
I don't think that's technically min-maxing, though. I think I used the term wrong, but I don't care. I'll do what I want.
Yeah, sometimes the games that I want to play are a little boring. I know you guys did not like that drone game. Maybe not the right game. That'd be a perfect game for a J stream, where I'll just play my drone game, I'll play Duskers, and Rich and Jay will talk about shit. There are certain games that are really meant for a J stream.
Key around somewhere, obviously, right?
Possibly. Loner Archon says, if Jack played XCOM with an assault character named Rich Evans, would Jack finish the game with no deaths?
Yes.
Well, I mean, duh. Duh.
All right.
I know. I love the drone game. The only problem with the drone game is I was too focused on it. And so then Rich had to do the majority of the talking, and that just puts a lot of burden on Rich, which is why if we had another talker in here, it'd be perfect. Just in the background, very minimal noise. It'd be perfect for a drowning out.
Jay would be trying to talk to me about some kind of obscure Swedish horror genre. And I don't know.
I don't know, but the chat would love it. Ooh, I've seen that obscure Swedish horror drama. Did you see the sequel? It was in Finnish.
So right now I'm doing demon things. No. I'm gonna wait till all the fucking DLCs out before I go back to XCOM 2. Okay.
That's fair.
I'll wait till they're done, and then I'll pick it up. Alright. Can't forget to pick those up before I end this level.
Oh, that's right. Jay was in the chat for the for Duskers. Yes, the Duskers does look boring, and you just have to trust me when I say it's super exciting. And it's super exciting for me. You guys might not find it as exciting as I find it. And I accept that, because people are different. Oh, did my mic turn off? There. Turn it back on. Turn it back on. Everything's okay now. Thank you. Duskers look like geometry homework. It's really hard for me to articulate why it's so engaging, but every ship is filled with this unspeakable, unseeable horror, and not being able to see the enemy and not being able to like react quickly. Maybe that's what it really is the inability to dodge roll. You know, you have to like type in a command code, and it's very clunky. The clunky way in which you have to react to danger is what makes it so exciting to me. Fudu V, I believe our plan this year is to completely and utterly ignore E3. Is that our plan for this year?
Sounds fine to me.
Great.
We don't have to watch the conferences. If you want, we can address news that comes out.
Sure.
If it's interesting news.
Sure.
Yeah. Stop.
Rich has played a little bit of Darkest Dungeon on stream. Yes. And felt okay about it. I forget how you feel about Darkest Dungeon, to be honest.
I know I wasn't super into the specific turn-based combat they had. Alright, I need another key. Oh, God. I need a hazmat suit. I don't know where to get one.
You know where to get one?
Oh, no, I don't. It's cut off. Oh wait, right. No. I can get these stairs. Alright, now where do I go from here to get out?
I like Stu91 says I like it when you shit on E3. But by now, like, we would just do another show where we say, "Yep, wait till the game comes out. Gameplay footage doesn't mean anything anymore." I mean, shills. We'll do a stream about it. We'll grab a fistful of paper with the news printed out on it, and we won't have to deal with the salesmanship.
Where did I need that key? I just needed that yellow key. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch.
Scarlet Spider, it was announced who Michael Keaton was playing in the new Spider-Man movie. Did you see it? Did you hear that?
Michael Keaton is in the new Spider-Man movie?
Michael Keaton has been cast in the new Spider-Man movie. Would you like to know who he's playing?
J. Jonah Jameson?
He's not playing J. Jonah Jameson.
Dr. Octopus? No
idea.
He's
not playing Dr. Octopus. He is playing a villain. I will give you that.
Okay.
So now you have to guess the villain that Michael Keaton would play.
Villain he would play is, I need to concentrate on this game because I'm kind of constantly on a timer right now because I've got to wear the hazmat suit.
Sorry.
No, it's fine.
He's playing the Vulture.
Yeah! Oh yeah, I forget he's old now. No, I swear to God, I forgot that the man is old.
Yeah, Michael Keaton's up there. So yeah, he's playing the Vulture, so it's already been announced. And, I mean, Michael Keaton's a great actor. So, great. It's great that he's cast in the movie that I want to do well.
I'm just going to grab the shit now before I forget it. All right, now I need... What do I need? I hate this map. What do you get me? Oh, yeah!
you did good?
I did good.
Great.
Zip.
All I know is Marissa Tomei is Aunt May, then Joe Pesci should be Uncle Ben.
That's a good one. That's a good one. Horrible Glory, that's a funny joke. For Aunt May, Marissa Tomei is fine.
No, yeah, she works. She works.
Peter Parker's only in his teens. His aunt wouldn't be that old.
Right. Aunt May does not need to be a frail old lady. I prefer it when Aunt May is not a frail old lady. Trying to save bullets.
Yeah.
Nice. Nice.
I'm not losing this.
I always had the impression that May was Peter's great aunt or something.
No, she's just his aunt.
Aunt May.
Oh, that was really easy.
Oh. Yep, just Aunt May, that's it. And she doesn't need to be an old lady.
Doom! No death!
That was it?
That was it.
Congratulations, Rich Evans. Doom, no death run. Brutal Doom. Not so brutal after. Not as brutal as Rich Evans.
The loathsome spider demon that masterminded the invasion of the moon bases and caused so much death has had its ass kicked for all time. A hidden doorway opens, and you enter. You've proven too tough for hell to contain. And now hell at last plays fair. For you emerge from the door to see the green fields of Earth, home at last. You wonder what's been happening on Earth while you were battling evil unleashed. It's good that no hellspawn could have come through that door with you. And there's the pet rabbit.
Oh, no!
Actually, that's the pet rabbit.
Oh, that's great. So is Doom 2, like, here?
Yeah.
This is where it starts? Yep. Oh, that's great. That's funny.
Technically, there's another... It was added on after the fact. There's a fourth episode to Doom 1, but I'm not going to play that.
Sure. That's great. You did it. You did it. That's horrifying. The bloody bunny head right there.
It's so appropriate, though, for Doom.
Incredibly appropriate. Yes. Incredibly, incredibly appropriate. And it worked out perfect. My stand-up timer just went off.
Okay.
So we should probably thank everybody and call it a night.
Oh, that sounds fun. Fine.
That sounds fun. Fine. That fun, sounds like fine.
Fine and fun. If you have clever names, it's always fun.
It's always
fun.
Hey,
save that.
It's fine fun. Let's keep it on the bunny.
Okay.
Then we can have the bunny in the back. Look at that bunny.
What about the music? Should
as
I turn
that? As we thank it. Well, once you click over, won't the music turn off?
Oh, that's true.
Yeah. All right.
What are we on here? There we are. Save Dro! Yes. 20 fucking months in a row. And just to spare the confusion, because we've had this issue with the YouTube videos cut up.
Yep.
They don't know why the fuck we start screaming people's names at the end of the stream.
Which a little bit of me likes. A little bit of me likes that.
We are thanking people who have subscribed while we've been playing the game tonight.
Yes. Like Sagan 1220 for 16 months in a row has subscribed to us.
Mudron!
Stu 91, 13 months in a row.
Biffin Bridge 9.
Frosty Snooze, 22 fucking months in a row.
And Rail Means Rail, 15 months in a row.
The real Quaid, 19 months in a row. Also, we only get these notifications if you subscribe or resubscribe during the stream. If you started subscribing to us off stream or like on a Friday,
offline,
yeah, then we, you know, these only are subscribers during the stream. So, heads up.
Otherwise, we don't know.
Otherwise, we don't
we
know.
Just don't know.
We just don't know.
Where'd you live from?
The real Quaid.
Lach Dannon.
Hans the Frosch.
It's Fishbus. 17 months in a row.
Mr. Bucket. 88.
Tear both eyes out.
X Mensa. 23 fucking months in a row.
So did you like hit in the head and become dumber and some Mensa had to kick you out? How do you become ex-Mensa?
Yeah. Yeah. You started
getting senile.
You were a Mensa member and then all of a sudden you're like, you know what, guys? I kinda like the Big Bang Theory. Get out right now. Get out right now.
Hair Tatsu! 16 months in a row.
Lando was taken 20 fucking months in a row.
Walt Heisenbeard, 20 fucking months in a row.
Sorry. I started looking at something else. They are Caesarian Fart, 13 months in a row.
Ragged Scribe.
Ice Bone Badger, 22 fucking months in a row.
Vapor Space, 21 fucking months in a row.
The Irish Nerd on Twitch.
Fleshy Patch, 20 fucking months in a row.
Fruit Pie, the Magician.
Master Kenobi, 007, 24 fucking months in a row.
Fisted by Dope Smoke, 18 months in a row.
Skeleton Bill.
Knark.
Knanork. Huggy Snuggle.
Sausage Toes, 17 months in a row.
J-Kid, 08.
Space Jack, 2084. Thank you all for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
It's true. We really do.
It's really true.
All right.
I don't think we have anything clever to do. So
we don't have anything clever. I'm just going to close. All right. Good night.